What's up, man?
Rambo.
So,
Genius,
I mean,
what's up, Ray?
Oh, yeah, y'all giving up for DJ Genius back there, man. Turning y'all up on a fine Sunday afternoon in the club. So, I mean, where do we begin, man? I mean, like I said earlier, man, this last year and a half has really been, like, quite a ride for you, man. I don't think we've seen a rise like this in quite some time, man.
Right.
I mean, we saw you. I mean, I think I got introduced to your music from, shit, YouTube. You had it down, the little Nirvana Baby cover. They yanked it down,
oh, yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
200,000 views, man. I thought my career was over with after that.
I know, man. So, I was like, that's how I got introduced to it. Then later on through TJ Chapman, of course, man. So, I mean, this last year and a half, just talk about that with us, man. I mean, I saw a lot of people snapping flicks and taking selfies with you. I don't think they really understand who you are and like what you went through to get this far, man.
Hey, man, it took a lot of hard work to get to this position I'm in now. Like, my tank, you know what I'm saying? I kept going. Hey, can we get some,
can we get some silence in the back, please?
Respect
silence.
My event. Respect the event, man. It took a lot of hard work, you know what I'm saying? My team, we all stayed focused, you know what I'm saying? We all kept our eyes on the prize. We stayed in the studio, we kept the grind up. We knew what we wanted. We knew where we was going with it. We ain't let nobody stop our, you know what I'm saying, our train. And we kept this shit moving. And we right here right now, man.
And what do you think it is that separated you from so many artists in Atlanta, man? I mean, some artists, they're doing their thing right now. Some of them, you know, hey, it's on minute 14 for their 15 minutes right now.
Yeah.
You know, you yourself, you've always been able to come with another hit and another hit and another hit, man. What do you think it is about you that separates you from so many else, man?
What it is about K-Count, man, I stayed true to myself. You know what I'm saying? I stayed in my lane. I made my type of music, you know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to make nobody else shit. I ain't trying to make what was popping. I made what I was feeling, you know what I'm saying, what came from the heart for me. And just doing me, man. It's like, it ain't really much to it. I just stay true to myself.
So, new album finally on the way, man. I mean, I kind of lost track, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you dropped so many songs and mixtapes, but this is the actual debut album.
This is the debut, man. This is what we work hard for.
You know, the one that you can buy in Best Buy and shit.
Yeah, for real.
So, you know, differently from the album, or is it going to be too different? Is it going to be a continuation of what you already been giving us? What direction did you go to on this album, man?
You're going to always get K-Camp in my music, you know what I'm saying? It's just, I have to say growth, you know what I'm saying? The lyrics is better, the beats is better, the content is better, you know what I'm saying? I'm seeing more shit, I'm learning more shit, I'm getting older, I'm getting wiser, and I can talk about more shit that makes sense, you know what I'm saying? Back in the day, I'm just rapping, you know what I'm saying? Like any other motherfucker just rapping, but now, it's more content. I'm telling my story, and I'm telling what I went through, you know what I'm saying? I'm proud of the album. It's my best working idea so far.
Some of this shit that you have seen, tell us about this, man. What are some specific things? What's some things going to
hear? Some shit. But nah, man, on this road, man, we've been on the road. In New Time put us on the road for a whole year. You know what I'm saying? And me, when I first got in the game, I ain't know the business. You know what I'm saying? I was just floating around, just trying to make music. And for me being able to step up as a leader, you know what I'm saying, and lead my squad and really put my team in a better position. I changed a lot of lives on my team, you know what I'm saying? And I only want to see my niggas grow, you feel me?
Y'all give it up for folks out here giving black people jobs, man. This man is employing people out here.
Right. That payroll crazy.
Man, so it's like, we saw another big move take place recently, man. You got on the coveted, the highly respected XXL Freshman 2015
career.
Y'all give it up for that, man.
No.
I really need y'all to act like y'all have seen this magazine.
Motherfucker,
no. At Kroger, at the bookstore, man. Don't act like this is on this little newspaper floating in the goddamn street, man. This XXL, he's on the cover of that thing, man.
Right.
I mean, we see a lot of code, see a lot of gold, man. Like, what was that experience for you, man? Like, shooting that cover. What did you even find out? How did they tell you? Because they act like it's such a secret leading up to it, man.
Yeah, it's damn sure a secret, but I think JR told me, and what's it? What you told me?
So how many lies did you have to tell? I mean, that's a hell of a secret to not get
out. I told
out.
Them lies. You know what I'm saying? I had to tell them, no, I don't know. You know what I'm saying? I had to tell them lies. They want that shit low key. But to be on that cover, you know what I'm saying? Everybody think I should have made it last year. You know what I'm saying? When I had Money Baby cut off and blessing when I was going crazy when I first popped. But, you know what I'm saying? I think everything happened for a reason. You know what I'm saying? My debut album dropping this year. They only came, they came perfect time. You know what I'm saying? Now the world CK Kemp, we about to fuck them up again.
I mean, so like when you're shooting that cover, man, I mean, like how do they do it? Like, are these guys that you were meeting for the first time? Was there anybody there that impressed you? Like, man, I ain't know about you, but you're actually kind of cool now.
The vibe was cool, you know what I'm saying? Everybody was in their own little space, you know what I'm saying? Everybody had their own little space where they was going, you know what I'm saying? OG Macko, everybody, you know, from the city. I didn't ran across a lot of these folks on the road anyway, so I knew the majority of them, you know what I'm saying? So everybody was cool, there wasn't no extra shit, you know what I'm saying? Everybody was tired as hell, and shit was all day, so niggas wanted to go home, for real.
I mean, birthday bash last night. Y'all give it up for K-Camp, man. This dude ripped birthday bash.
Yeah.
Damn near set the standard for the rest of the night up there, man. I mean, you know, that's the big thing in Atlanta, bro. That's right. Like our summer jam. That's right. Our BET Awards. That's right. Our everything, man.
It's big for me, you know what I'm saying? Because I think that was my third time in Birthday Bash. The first time I went to Birthday Bash, I felt like a hype man, you know what I'm saying? I was doing ad-libs for another nigga song, you know what I'm saying? So for me to I was a headline, you know what I'm saying? I was a big fly, so I guess I was a headline. For me to be out there.
Your name was on the flyer,
right. I was a headline, you know what I'm saying? I went a little early, but shit, same thing. But, you know what I'm saying, for me to be out there and standing for something in my own city, and the city showing me love like that, all that hard work I put in, I appreciate it, you know what I'm saying? That means I'm doing something right. You feel me?
For sure, man. So it's like, we're here at the Core DJs, you know what I'm saying? Like, talk about the importance of, you know, DJs to your career right now, man. Because, I mean, you know, shout out to the homie, you know, DJ MLK. He was one of the first people spinning it.
Yeah,
you
what know? MLK here?
I don't know if he's in here.
Shout out MLK.
No, but like, talk about the importance, you know, like of DJs, you know, to K-Camp success, man.
Hey, man, without the DJs, there's no K-Camp. You know what I'm saying? I appreciate the DJs 110%, you know what I'm saying? Because they the one spinning my records. They the one breaking my shit, you know what I'm saying? I remember back in the day, back in the mariachi days, we was putting in that footwork, going to Club Libra, wasting Wednesdays and shit, giving Tank $20 to spend all night, you know what I'm saying? DJ Geronimo, $20 to spend all night. So that shit go a long way, man. It's all about building relationships and keeping that relationship with the DJs and making sure they fuck with you. Because I fuck with the DJs, but you got to make sure that the feeling is mutual, you know what I'm saying? And I ain't never... If any
y'all
DJ here know,
y'all can clap for that, man. Yeah. Y'all can clap for that.
You know what I'm saying? Any DJ that know me, anybody in the city that know me, they know I have never changed since I started this shit. You know what I'm saying? I've been the same humble nigga, still working. You know what I'm saying? I don't let the fame change, but I just work for it.
I mean, even this shit ain't changing you, though, man. I mean, you out here on the beach and shit, on the boat. I mean, that ain't gonna change you either, bro. I mean,
hey, man, I'm riding camels and shit. I'm still the same nigga. You feel me?
So, man, I mean. Now that you're, like, you know, you got signed to Interscope not too long ago, man. Like talk about, you know, the, you know, coming up, you know, independent, now being on a record label. Like, you know, was there any pressure on you to like try to change the sound or work with niggas that you don't even know like that? You know, like what has that experience been like for you, man?
Shit, I say the difference is, if you want my honest opinion, when I was independent, we was going crazy independent. You know what I'm saying? We was running it up, and I feel. Independent, you can do shit more freely. You know what I'm saying? You can drop a record, drop some shit, boom, 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 boom. But with a label, it's more slow. Now, I wouldn't say slow motion, but you gotta play your role, man. You gotta let a single build and you gotta do, you know what I'm saying? You gotta let shit move at this time, you know what I'm saying? So I appreciate the label, you know what I'm saying? The relationship at my label is 100. You know what I'm saying? We all on the same page. They not trying to change K-Camp. They keep me the way I came in because I'm not going to change. I'm not going to go to the label and do some funky shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to stay the way I came in. So I salute my label. You know what I'm saying? Independent grind is more pressure. You know what I'm saying? You really got to come out your own pockets and make that shit work. But at the same time, you sign to a label, you still coming out your pocket. So I appreciate both. You know what I'm saying? I can't complain. I'm winning.
And talk about the experience of being a boss earlier, man. Because, I mean, you know, we gave you plenty of salute for employing folks out here, man. But what has that experience been like? You know, what are the jewels that you're passing down to, you know, the artists that are going to be following behind you now, man? Like, what are the things that you're telling them?
Man, really, I just feel like I'm setting an example. You know what I'm saying? All eyes on me now. So however I move is being watched. And I got to watch the way I move. And I got to lead in the right way. You know what I'm saying? I got to keep my team positive. I got to keep my team on the right track. I gotta make sure my niggas know how to get a check, you know what I'm saying? I can't have nobody on my squad lacking, you feel me? So with that being said, we're gonna keep moving. We're gonna keep this shit going. If you and me, we moving, cause I don't ever stop.
You better get a bag, nigga. Check, check, check. I have to give me a bag. 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 I have to give me a bag.
What
we got next is you want to do that, James.
Turn up, James.
What's up, Mambo Rambo? Where that dick with all that?
What's up?
What's up, Mambo Rambo?
You got that club, don't
you? I got the trap house, I got the money to power, I got the young hood alert. My bitch got a big payroll, and I do too. I'm kind of top of the world. Straight out the door, straight out the tank. I know it hurt, PLSA. Her on the tank, she made me sick. Smoking the kush, give a look. Trap house, I'm like Tremblay. Pull a real clean look, kind of like Neverland.
Met a little bitch named Diamond Ring.
Right, that's kicking diamonds off by the ass.
Diamond Ring.
Talk to me, bitch, I like the final things. Pull up in a hall, black clothes with a link leg. Middle life, big, big thing.
Till I make a string.
Put on the bullshit, nigga, we the dream team. Ring it.
Got trapped out, motherfucker.